Now let's look at the 37th example. Mark this as an important one. So if you look at the example, we need to find the value of dy by dx if x power 2 by 3 plus y power 2 by 3 is equal to a power 2 by 3. See, generally if this question is given in miscellaneous exercise, what we will do is we will generally try to proceed using the implicit form. Okay, so here it is slightly complicated. We can do it using the parametric coordinates also. See, observe the idea that I am taking. So what is the idea that I am going to use is, I have x power 1 by 3 the whole square plus y power 1 by 3 the whole square is equal to, can I write it as a power 1 by 3 the whole square? This x power 1 by 3, I will call it as some capital X. So capital X square plus capital Y square is equal to, I will call this a power 1 by 3 as capital A square. If you observe this, this is looking like the equation of a circle with center at origin. So for equation of a circle with center at origin, what are the parametric coordinates? Parametric coordinates are the radius cos theta and y is equal to the radius sin theta. But here, what is the value of x? The value of x is capital X is x power 1 by 3. The value of capital A is a power 1 by 3 cos theta. So what is the substitution we are supposed to do? X is equal to a cos cube theta. Similarly, if you do the same operation here, then you will understand that y should be substituted as a sin cube theta. So this is the idea behind what value, behind thinking on what value is supposed to be substituted. So here, let x is equal to a cos cube theta and y is equal to a sin cube theta. See, in the textbook he would have directly taken this value, but I'm trying to explain what is the logic behind it. And one more important point is, had the question been x power 2 by 3 minus y power 2 by 3 is equal to a power 2 by 3, then in the place of x and y, you can either think of secant theta and tan theta or cosecant theta and cot theta. Because secant square theta minus tan square theta will be 1. Similarly, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta will be 1. That is when you have a minus sign here. But here, since the question is having a plus sign, I am taking sine and cos. There is a simple difference. Now, what we can do is, we have converted it to the parametric form. Now, find dy by dx. We will do dx by d theta. So, dx by d theta is a into derivative of cos cube is 3 cos square theta into derivative of cos theta is minus sine theta. Similarly, dy by d theta will be equal to a into 3 sine square theta into derivative of sine theta will be cos theta. Then what is dy by dx? So dy by dx is dy by d theta divided by dx by d theta. So 3a sine square theta cos theta the whole divided by 3a cos square theta into minus sin theta. I have taken the minus outside. So 3a, 3a gets cancelled. One sin is gone and one cos is gone. So the answer will be minus tan theta. But here, since theta is not given, you are not supposed to leave the answer like this. You need to bring it back to the value of x and y, because the parametric form is not given in the question. It is we who created. So whichever is not given in the question should not be there. So tan theta means what? So we have x is equal to a cos cube theta, y is equal to a sin cube theta. If I do y by x, what is that we are going to get? We will do a sin cube theta divided by a cos cube theta. A and a will get cancelled. There is going to be tan cube theta. Then what is tan theta? So tan theta will be y by x power 1 by 3. Right? So dy by dx is equal to, since dy by dx is minus tan theta, instead of this, we will write it as minus 1 y by x to the power 1 by 3, which is nothing but the cube root of y by x.